First, it was oozing lava streaming into residential areas on Hawaii's Big Island. Now, it looks as if Kilauea might be ready to explode. Overnight, the U.S. Geological Survey issued a warning that a volcano could turn explosive, as falling lava levels inside the crater bring hot rock closer to cool groundwater. Already, the active peak has seen smaller-scale bursts, as rock slides fall into the volcano's crater and create plumes of ash. Until recently, the biggest threats from the volcano were this slow-moving lava inundation and inhaling the hazardous sulfur dioxide released from the molten rock. Since the volcano began actively erupting last week, more than 1,000 people have been evacuated, and at least 26 homes have been destroyed. Dramatic video footage even showed lava engulfing a parked car. But a large crater called Halemaumau sits near the center of Kilauea, and it's filled with a lake of bright red and yellow lava. Since late April, that lake has been receding into its magma column, the vertical passage that brings magma from Earth's interior up to the crater. Volcanologist Janine Krippner suspects the magma is either moving to a different storage area in the volcano or to the East Drift Zone, where fissures have been oozing lava, but the magma's movements can't be predicted with complete certainty. Confused about the difference between magma and lava? Here are the facts. If the lava lake recedes far enough, it will move below the water table, allowing water to enter the crater and creating steam. More rocks falling into the crater could then form a cap over the steam, eventually building up so much pressure that the rock cap explodes. We are looking at the possibility of a steam-driven eruption at the summit, which is not as large as magmatic eruptions that we see at volcanoes like Mount St. Helens, Krippner says. The hazards are ballistic rocks around the summit area, and ashfall can occur in areas depending on wind strength and direction and the size of the eruption. Such dramatic action from Hawaii's famously gentle volcano is very rare. The peak has not seen this kind of major explosive eruption since 1924, when a steam-powered eruption caused more than 50 explosions over 2.5 weeks. The blast sent chunks of rock weighing as much as 14 tons hurling through the air. Similarities between then and now have scientists concerned, but it's tricky to predict when and with how much force Kilauea might explode in this fashion. The magma is a constantly changing system, we cannot see below the surface to actually look at what is going on, says Krippner. We see what is happening now, and we know a bit about what happened the last time, so we can give warnings about what might happen next, but not with certainty.
As a Hawaii island community was inundated with lava erupting from the Kilauea volcano.
I'll provide that support as needed. We have two teams on the ground that's composed of our
as if Hawaii Island community was inundated with lava erupting from the Kilauea volcano, the Hawaii National Guard was activated, calling soldiers and airmen to perform their state mission to ensure that residents of Hawaii County are safe and that their property remains secure.
Task Force Hawaii has been established by the Hawaii National Guard. It's composed of airmen and soldiers from the Army and the Air National Guard. And what we do in Task Force Hawaii is we mission command or command and control the organizational assets and resources that are here on island, on the Big Island, in response to assistance as requested by the County of Hawaii. So what we've done is we've established several teams that are working with the first responders on the Big Island. One team is the aviation element. They're working with the Hawaii Fire Department and their aviation element to provide that support as needed. We have two teams on the ground that's composed of our security team that go out through the neighborhoods in response to requests from Hawaii County Police Department in regards to presence patrols. And then we have traffic control points and checkpoints to control the flow in and out of the affected area.
The security teams provided 24-hour support of communities at specific checkpoints.
Our typical shift is we man a post. We have about 5 posts set up. We make sure no one is allowed in or out. If people is allowed in, we let them know what the status is on the inside.
Command and control was provided at a joint emergency operations center where the ever-evolving conditions on the ground changed as new volcanic fissures opened each day.
When it first developed, the Hawaii National Guard Joint Operations Center stood up a very small initial response. But over time, the incident has grown in scope and in danger in regards to the lava and where the lava is, especially in the Leilani Estates and then the East Rift Zone. So we've had to increase the amount of personnel on the ground and amount of resources that we have to apply in order to assist the county in their efforts to help the community respond to whatever Pele does and then also hasten the recovery of the community when all of this is over.
A public affairs team was also dispatched to assist Hawaii County authorities with on-site lava coverage and also coordinated media inquiries from international, national, and local media outlets. National Guard civil support teams from Hawaii's 93rd CST and Arizona's 91st CST provided around-the-clock monitoring of sulfur dioxide levels that protected both first responders and residents of Puna. Members of the community were very grateful for the support.
Like, I have a lot of friends and family that live in Leilani Estates, and to just them knowing I'm here helping their community, it means a lot to them. Like local people helping our friends and family, our community, it means a lot to the community.
Plans are also being developed in the possible case scenario where a large section of the community gets cut off by an active lava flow. This is Tech Sergeant Andrew Lee Jackson reporting with the Hawaii National Guard.